Hello students, this is Savita Pawar. Welcome to my channel Get the Math. In this video we are going to see the solutions of exercise 7.2 of lesson 7, triangles. In the I link above I have shared the video of exercise 7.1. It is very necessary to go through that video because all the detailed explanation I have done in that video about what is meant by congruency of triangle and what are the rules or the conditions to prove that the triangles are congruent. Now in this exercise there is a theorem. We are going to consider the isosceles triangle, and the theorem is angles opposite to the equal sides of an isosceles triangle are equal. So here we are going to prove that the angles opposite to the equal sides of the isosceles triangle are equal, that is B and C are equal, since AB is equal to AC because this is an isosceles triangle. So in this exercise also you have to write given to prove and proof, that the same we did in exercise 7.1. So given is ABC is an isosceles triangle where AB is equal to AC, that is given. You have to prove that B equal to C. So write the proof here. Draw a bisector of angle A and meet BC at point D here. Now consider this triangle and this triangle. In triangle BAD and triangle CAD here, write whatever the given things are, those are equal, that is AB equal to AC, angle BAD is equal to angle CAD, since AD is the bisector. Bisector means it divides the angle into two equal halves, and AD is common for both the triangles. This is AD is common for both the triangles, and therefore the triangles are congruent. This is the symbolic representation for congruency. Therefore triangle BAD is congruent to triangle CAD, and you have to write the rule by which it is congruent. So this is side angle and side, so it is side angle side, and therefore the required thing is equal, that is ABD is equal to ACD, or angle B equal to angle C by CPCT, that is corresponding parts of congruent triangles. So this theorem we are going to use for exercise 7.2. Let us start with exercise 7.2. In an isosceles triangle ABC, where AB is equal to AC given, the bisectors of angle B and angle C intersect each other at point O, join AO, show that OB equal to OC and AO bisects angle A. Okay, so these many things you have to show here. So they were asked here that this is the bisector, BE is the bisector of angle B and CF is the bisector of angle C. So if it is bisector, the angle is divided into two equal halves, this one, and this is equal to this, and this is also equal to this one. Okay, and you have to prove that OB, this OB equal to OC. So first of all write the given. In triangle ABC, AB equal to AC, and therefore these angles, base angles, that is angle B and angle C, will be equal by theorem 7.2. Take the half of those two angles, since OB and OC are bisectors of angle B and C. So it becomes angle ABO, this one, angle ABO will be equal to angle ACO. The triangle that we have to take, I have split the figure and shown you here. Now you have to prove that this OB equal to OC and OA bisects angle A. Okay, so let us start with the proof now. Consider the triangle. In triangle ABO and triangle ACO, AB is equal to AC, that is given. Angle ABO equal to angle ACO, that we have proved above. And AO is equal to AO, since it is common side for both the triangles. Therefore, for congruency you write, you have to write the same names that you have taken above, and just in place of and put the symbol of congruency. Therefore, triangle ABO is congruent to triangle ACO, and you have to write the rule, that is SAS, by which they are congruent. Then you have to write the CPCT. CPCT is OB equal to OC, that is the CPCT, that this side is equal to this side. This side is equal to this side now. OB equal to OC here. And the next one is angle. The next one is angle BAO will be equal to angle CAO. So these both are by CPCT. Okay. BAO, that is this angle and this angle, these two are also equal, that we have proved. So now since these two are equal here, therefore OA bisects angle A. Therefore here you can write, therefore OA bisects angle A. Okay, so that was your question 1. Question 2 here, it is given that ABC is a triangle and AD is perpendicular bisector of the perpendicular bisector of BC. Perpendicular bisector means it is dividing the other side into two equal halves. Therefore BD will be equal to CD here, and the angle will be 90 here. Show that ABC is an isosceles triangle. So you have to prove that this is an isosceles triangle. So that is a given, right? In triangle ABC, AD is perpendicular bisector of BC and BD is equal to CD. To prove ABC is an isosceles triangle, consider triangle ABD and ACD. So here BD is equal to CD since AD bisects BC. Then this angle and this angle are 90, that ADB and ADC are 90, and AD is common for both the triangle. Therefore the triangles are congruent by SAS. Okay, and the remaining thing, that AB equal to AC, the sides of the triangle, they will be equal by CPCT, and as the two sides are equal, therefore the triangle is isosceles triangle. So this way you have to write the statements, that is very much important. ABC is an isosceles triangle here, which has altitudes BE and CF, these are altitudes here, are drawn to equal sides for AC and AB. So AC and AB are the equal sides. These are the equal sides. Show that these altitudes are equal. So you have to prove that these altitudes are equal. So you have to consider this figure from the part, this is the part of the figure from the whole figure. So ABC is an isosceles triangle. This is perpendicular, so these angles are 90, and CF is also perpendicular, so these two angles will also be 90. You have to prove that BE equal to CF. Okay, so start with the proof now. Here this is question 3 proof. So in triangle ABE and triangle ACF, angle AEB equal to angle AFC equal to 90 degree. Angle A is equal to angle A. You can see here angle A is common for both these triangles. So angle A is common. And the third thing is, that is given is AB is equal to AC, that is given. So therefore the triangle ABE will be congruent to triangle ACF by angle angle side. Why? This is angle angle and this is side. Okay, and therefore the required thing, that is BE is equal to CF by CPCT, corresponding parts of congruent triangles. So this is equal to, this BE is equal to CF. That we have to prove. Question 4, a similar one, but the triangle which altitudes B and CF to sides AB are equal. Now here the altitudes have been given equal, that this is equal to this has been given equal. In the previous question we have proved that these are equal. We have to show that the triangles are congruent and AB is equal to AC, that is ABC is an isosceles triangle, that we have to prove. So write the given here. In triangle ABC, this is perpendicular, B is perpendicular to AC. Therefore, this and this angle will be equal to 90. CF is perpendicular to AB. Therefore, CFA and CFB will also be equal to 90. You have to prove that ABE is congruent to ACF and AB is equal to AC. Therefore, this triangle is an isosceles triangle. Okay? So, from this figure now, AEB, this is, and this is 90, angle A is common here, and B and CF are given equal, therefore these two triangles will be congruent to each other by AAS. These two triangles will be congruent to each other by AAS, and therefore this one AB will be equal to AC, and therefore the triangle is isosceles triangle. Question 5 here, there are two triangles, this side is given equal to this and this is equal to this, BD is equal to CD, AB equal to AC. You have to show that this whole angle ABD is equal to ACD here. So first we will consider ABC triangle, that is in triangle ABC, in triangle ABC. Here AB is equal to AC given, and that is given, you have to write, given. Therefore, from theorem 7.2, ABC will be equal to angle ACB. That let be your equation number 1. Why? The reason is here, that is, I will write the reason here, that is, angles opposite to equal sides are equal. Okay. Now consider the next triangle, that is downward facing triangle, this one. So in triangle BDC, DB is equal to BC, that is given. Angle DBC is equal to angle DCB. Let that be your equation number 2. Since the sides are equal, therefore angles are equal. And the reason is same here that you have to write. Angles opposite to equal sides are equal. Now add equation 1 and 2. So on adding, you will write it here as angle ABC plus angle DBC equal to angle ACB from 1 plus angle DCB from 2. On adding this, you will get it as angle ABD is equal to angle ACD. This is what we require, hence prove. Okay. So, on adding this angle and this angle, it becomes a total angle as ABD, and adding this angle and this angle, it will become the total angle as ACD. Question 6 here. So, this is a isosceles triangle ABC here. Its sides equal are AB and AC. Then BA side is produced to D such that AD is equal to AB. Okay. So, if AB is equal to AC and AB is equal to AD, so all these three are equal. So, you have to prove that BCD, this C is 90 degree or right angle you have to prove. So, write the given. ABC is isosceles, so AB equal to AC. ACD is also isosceles as AC equal to AD. So all the three sides AB, AC and AD are equal. You have to prove BCD is right angle, that is C is 90 degree. So first we will consider the vertical angle ACD here. So in triangle ACD, what things are equal that you have to write? That is AB equal to AC, that is given. And if it is given, therefore this angle will be equal to this angle that you will write. That is angle D or angle ACD will be equal to angle D. Okay, that is your equation 1. Then consider the horizontal triangle ABC here. Same thing, AB will be equal to AC. Okay, sorry, this one here should be in triangle ACD. AD will be equal to this one. This should be AD. AD is equal to AC, and in this one ABC, here AB equal to AC. Therefore, angle B, this implies that angle B will be equal to angle ACB. That is your equation number 2. Now consider the whole triangle. So, angle D plus angle B plus angle, the third one is BCD, is equal to 180. Okay. So, now substitute the values of D and B from equation 1 and 2. So, for angle D, we will write it as angle ACD. And for angle B, we will write it as angle ACB plus angle, the remaining same thing, BCD equal to 180. That is from 1 and 2. Okay. Now, if you add these two things, you will see ACD and ACB, it will be the whole angle. If you add these two, this will be the whole angle. So, in place of this, you will write it as angle BCD plus angle BCD equal to 180. So, it will be 2 times angle BCD equal to 180. So, angle BCD is 180 by 2, that is 90 degrees. So, we have proved that BCD is a right angle or angle C is 90 degree. So, this is the way to solve your question number 6. Question number 7 here. ABC is a right angle at A. So, angle A is 90 here. And AB equal to AC, that is given. You have to find angle B and angle C. So, write the given, ABC is a right angle triangle, A is 90 then, and AB equal to AC, you have to find B and C. So, write the proof, in triangle ABC, AB equal to AC and let B equal to C, that be X here, because angles opposite to equal sides are equal, that is theorem 7.2. Therefore, A plus B plus C, add all the angles of that triangle equal to 180. A is 90 here, we know. B and C are X and 180. So, find the value of X here. You will get it as 45. So, that is angle B and C both are 45. So, this is question 8 here now. Show that all the angles of equilateral triangle are each 60. So, ABC here is an equilateral triangle. For equilateral triangle, we know all the sides are equal. We have to prove all the angles are equal to 60 degree. So, let us start with the proof here. So, we will write it here as, let in triangle ABC, so here AB is equal to AC, that is given, two sides are already equal. So, their angles opposite to that will also be equal here. So, that is equation 1. Then similarly, in triangle ABC again, consider the two different sides now, AB equal to BC here, so that is given, for AB equal to BC, angle C will be equal to angle A now. That is equation number 2. And therefore, from 1 and 2, you can see C equal to B and C equal to A. Therefore, from 1 and 2, all the angles are equal. That is angle A equal to angle B equal to angle C here. That is your equation number 3. Now, in triangle ABC again, angle A, add all the angles. You know some of the all the angles are equal to 180 degrees. But as all the angles are equal, you can substitute all B and C as A only. So, angle A plus angle A plus angle A equal to 180. So, 3 times angle A equal to 180. So, angle A equal to 180 by 3, that is 60 degrees. And therefore, as angle A equal to angle B equal to angle C, and all are equal to 60 degrees, and hence proved. So, hence proved. Okay, so this was the last question of exercise 7.2. If you have any doubt or any query, drop it in the comment box. Do like, share and subscribe my channel, Get the Math.